Shalom. May the grace of God be with you as you participate or join with me in this devotion. Our scripture reading is found in Hebrews 7 verse 25. Therefore, he is able to save completely those who come to God through him, because he always lives to intercede for them. He is able to help those who are being tempted. King Nebuchadnezzar summoned all the government officers in his kingdom to gather them at the plain of Dura. In front of them was an impressive golden image that the king had set. The decree was to bow down and worship the golden image as a sign of loyalty to the king. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was among the crowd. They knew that to worship the image was a betrayal to their God, Jehovah. Another decree was pronounced that those who refused to bow down and worship the golden image would be thrown into the fiery furnace. The Hebrew boys had made the decision not to worship the image, but chose to be thrown into the fiery furnace. They told the king, "If we are thrown into the blazing fire, the God we serve is able to save us from it, and he will rescue us from your hand. But if he does not, we want you to know that we will not serve your gods, nor do we worship the image of gold that you have set up." What trust and confidence they have in Jehovah, their God, that he is able to save them from the fiery furnace. In his anger, King Nebuchadnezzar had the Hebrew officer thrown into the fiery furnace. But God entered the fiery furnace with them, and the fire has no power over them. Then King Nebuchadnezzar leaped to his feet in amazement and asked his advisor, "Weren't three men that we tied and threw into the fire?" They replied, "Certainly, O king." He said, "Look, I see four men walking around in the fire, unbound and unharmed. And the fourth looks like a son of the gods." Daniel 3, verses 24-25. Nebuchadnezzar then approached the opening of the blazing furnace and shouted, "Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servant of the Most High God, come out, come here." So they came out of the fire, and all the government officers crowded around them. They saw that the fire had no harm their bodies, nor was a hair of their heads singed. Their robes were not scorched, and there was no smell of fire on them. It was Jesus himself who went into the fiery furnace with them. In Isaiah 43, verses 2-3, the Lord said, "When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, they shall not be burned, nor shall the flames scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior." Christian legend stated that the Apostle John was the only disciple of Jesus that died a natural death. The rest died of martyrdom. However, John, before he was exiled to Patmos, was thrown into the boiling oil. But Jesus rescued him. In the boiling oil was a cool, refreshing bath to him. The scripture says, "Therefore, he is able to save completely those who come to God through him, because he always lives to intercede for them. He is able to help those who are being tempted." Hebrews 7, verse 25. We are living in a perilous time. We live among the wicked and corrupt people. The Apostle Paul described the kind of people living in the last days. In 2 Timothy 3, verses 1-5, he says, "But mark this, There will be troubled times in the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to the parents, ungrateful, unholy without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, have nothing to do with them. Prophet Ezekiel described the government during his days. He said, there is a conspiracy of her princes within her, like a roaring lion tearing its prey. They devour people, take treasures and precious things, and make many widows within her. They are like roaring lion and charging bear. It's a wicked man running over the helpless people. Proverbs 28 verse 15. Satan is behind all the wickedness that happened in the world today. Therefore, we are warned by Scripture, be self-controlled and alert. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. Resist him. Stand firm in the faith, because you know that your brothers throughout the world are undergoing the same kind of suffering. During the time that our movement are controlled due to COVID-19 pandemic, we need to spend this precious time studying the Word of God. We need to be on our knees and pray for God's protection. We need to fast and seek God. We need to cry out like David, search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. Point out anything in me that offends you and lead me along the path everlasting. Jesus Christ is coming soon. He is ready to return to this world and take his people to that home he has prepared for them. He said, here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and eat with him and he with me. To him who overcomes, I will give the right to sit with me in my throne, just as I overcame and sat down with my Father on his throne. Dear friends, do you believe that God is able to save you from the virus of sin? Jesus has special vaccine for it, his own blood. Do you believe that God can shield you from the deadly coronavirus? Psalms 91 verses 3 to 8 has a promise from the Almighty God. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wing you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies during the day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If God is able to do great things and marvelous things before, he can do it now. Just have complete faith in him, because he is able. Father, we thank you that you are able to save us even from this COVID-19 and the virus of sin, because your Son has come and provide that vaccine of your blood. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.